All right, man. We got the canola oil. We got the apple core. We got potatoes, and we got the fry daddy. The presto fry daddy. Press that button. Booyah! Opens up. We're gonna fill that. Got your little basket in there. See the little min-max line? Min-max. That's where you put your oil. We're gonna do homemade potato wedges. And some grilled ground chuck, 80-20 ground chuck burgers with homemade potato wedges dipped in ketchup. They're going to be good. Canola oil is really good. Peanut oil is the best, but they didn't have any peanut oil, so I had to settle for canola oil, which is pretty good. It's a good frying oil. And with this, it automatically sets the temperature with this cool daddy here. Deep fryer elite. It sets the temperature, so when you put your stuff in, you know, you're not going to infuse any oil, maybe just a little bit, into the food that you're cooking, whether it be fish, chicken. In my case, it's going to be hand-cut potato wedges. So it's going to be good. We'll be back. Fill this baby up. Let's get the game started. Okay, we got the oil in. All I gotta do is now is take the potatoes and this, by the way, guys, this Faberware is awesome. It's used for coring apples, but it works great on potatoes. It makes real nice potato wedges. Real nice. I love using this thing. Okay, we got the ground chuck. Got the Lipton Recipe Secrets. Lipton Onion Soup Mix. We're going to fold that in there and get that good mixed up. We're going to put some other spices in there. A little bit of garlic powder. A little bit of Lee and Perrins. You guys know what that Lee and Perrins is. I mean, that stuff's killer. And a couple drops of A1 and about a teaspoon of water. We'll get that mixed up. This will make 3 1/3-pound patties. We're going to start heating that fry daddy up, get these potatoes cut up with the apple core, get some nice potato wedges going, and it's going to be great. We'll be back. All right, burger patties are already made up. 3 1/3-pounders. Looking good. Now we make up the potato wedges. Using this handy dandy apple coring device. Love using that, man. Look at it, man. They look good enough to eat raw. Lipton onion soup mix, baby. That's how you do it. Got a little Lee and Perrins in there. Some other stuff. Gonna be good. All right, man. All right, all right. We got the potato wedges all made up. Check it out. With this apple core. You're left with this core here, and I just throw the core away. But look, it makes these perfect potato wedges. Look at that. See that? You just take that and push down on it, and they just come right out. Kind of hard to do with one hand, but they just pop right out. That's plenty. That's more than enough. Nice plate of, we'll get these babies seasoned up, and, get this fry daddy going here, heating up, put the burgers on, and it's going to be good. Real good. Quick little update video. I'm putting together a longer video. I just want to show you guys here. The rain is starting to transition over to snow. As you can see in the video here, it's starting to snow. I got the fry daddy oil heating up. I have the grill heating up. I already made up all my potato wedges. Used 4 potatoes. And I got 3 beautiful 1/3-pound ground chuck burgers. Made up perfectly with Lipton onion soup recipe dry mix. A little bit of Lee and Perrins. Half a teaspoon. I won't tell you how much of A1 sauce. And a little bit of other goodies. Some garlic powder. Just a tiny little bit. And some other stuff. But yep, it's starting to snow. And we are going to grill and make some. Use that fried daddy, make some nice homemade potato wedges. In the restaurant, man, they charge you like $6 for like well, actually not at at the local deli up the street. They charge you like $6 for a dozen potato wedges, and they're not nearly as good as the ones I make. But I'm making about 24. I don't know. We'll see. And then the total cost of me is $1.49 for the oil, and I think about maybe 10 cents per potato. I don't know. Do it yourself, save some money. Everybody's good. Yep, look at the snow mixing in. Hell yeah. Let it snow, baby. Cody B, you watching this? I know you're getting some snow out your way. You had an ice storm and a lot of others. Some of my subs up out in Pennsylvania. Well, I know Display Fireworks 1 and some other guys out there. Airwolf 1. You guys are getting snow or will be getting snow. Yellowgroove. All right. Flakes are flying, baby. It's snowing. It is snowing. Horizontal snow. You gotta love that. Welcome to April. April 1st, 2018. Sunday. What do you think about that? Snow in April. I'm not even in the mountains. I'm now out west in the Rocky Mountains. You guys get like snow at the peaks of the mountains and the passes and all that way through May, even into like June sometimes. But here, where we're like only a few hundred feet above sea level, I think my elevation is 373 feet above sea level. This is not normal crap here for April. No, it ain't. Anyway, potato wedges getting ready to go in. Grill's heated up. Getting ready to throw these burgers on. I'll show you guys something real quick. Grill's heating up. Got the burger 1, 2, and 3 made up perfectly with all my proprietary mix. However you say that word. I've been drinking some 211. But you can see the onions and dehydrated onions. And there's garlic powder in there. There's a little bit of Liam Perrins. All the good stuff, basically. And we're going to throw them on. The oil's preheated in the fry daddy. Got the potato wedges ready to go. Throw them potato wedges, handmade, hand-cranked potato wedges. 5 to 6 minutes on the potato wedges per batch. I'm going to make 2 batches. 1, 2. 2 batches. Take a look at this grill. We're going to spray some of this good Weber on there. Grill spray. Non-stick grilling. The only non-flammable grill spray. And it's true. I sprayed this with an open flame with a Bic lighter and it wouldn't light. So that cheap stuff you buy in the grocery stores, it'll flame up on you. You don't want that. Yellowgroove. Let's check it out. It is snowing like crazy. Welcome to April. Welcome to April in the OV. Wow. It's already starting to coat. Look at it. Look at the grill. It's already starting to accumulate on the grill top here. This stuff means business. This is crazy. It's snowing, baby. It is snowing. In April. On April 1st. Easter. Which happens to be April Fool's Day. It's a big April Fool's Day joke from Mother Nature. Thank you very much. All right, enough of that. Burgers are on and it is snowing. Woo, nice. Check it out. Hell yeah, snow will add moisture to the burgers as I cook. Gotta go in and get my potato wedges in the fry daddy. All right, the oil's ready, heated up. It's snowing like crazy. I got the burgers on. Let's put the first couple potato wedges in there. When you do this, you got to be careful. You pat them down with some paper towels, but it's going to make a lot of noise. We're going to go about 6 minutes on this, and we'll be right back. Check out the snow coming down now, folks. Big flakes, huge flakes. You've got to be kidding me. Look at it, it's starting to really accumulate on the grill. My TV stand. Burgers are cooking. Potato wedges are looking good. That is insane. April 1st. And it's not an April Fool's Day joke. Happy Easter, everyone. Look at the snow. Alright, show you guys what these potato wedges look like when they're done. Nice, crispy, golden brown. We're about to put this second batch in. Got the basket here, so... Oh, these are looking real good. Ooh, get them out of there. We'll be right back. Get these babies out. All right, it's snowing like crazy. Burgers just are getting ready to flip. I just flipped the burgers. Look at this. Look at the snow coming down, folks. Nice grill marks. Could have cooked these babies for another 5 to 6 minutes. The first batch of potato wedges are done. Second batch is already in. And look at the snow. It's already accumulating. Here we go. We'll do a YG for yellowgroove in the snow, baby. There you guys go. For you in the snow. What you know about the snowstorm in April? You guys from the Southwest and California and LA and Miami. You don't see this very often, do you? In April or any time of the year. No, you don't. Nice. Burgers are ready, baby. Look at that. We're about to put the nice, big, thick slices of a mild cheddar cheese on them. It's a Weber, baby. Potato wedges are done. Look at that. Perfectly golden brown potato wedges. Oh, come on. Yellowgroove. Look at them bad boys, huh? Oh, yeah. Time to throw some cheese on the burgers. We'll be right back. All right, all right, all right. It's go time, baby. It's snowing still. Three batches of potato wedges. And, look, these burgers are ripe and ready. Cheese time, baby. Cheese time. We're doing this. We're going to cut the burners off on the front and the middle, and we're going to keep the back burner on low. We got some nice, thick Sargento of Wisconsin mild cheddar cheese. Not that cheap crap. And let's go ahead and let it do its thing. We got three pieces of foil. We're gonna wrap each one in foil. We're gonna put a little ketchup on there and wrap them. It's gonna be good. Oh my goodness, it's worth all the wait with this. Look at the snow. Look at this, guys. My YG I did earlier. It's already. We get about almost a quarter of an inch. YG yellowgroove. There's a snowball. Booyah! Do a salute. All right, guys. Burgers are off the grill. Wrapped in foil. Potato wedges are nestled under this nice little aluminum tent. Let's take a peek. Homemade potato wedges. Look at that. Oh, look at that, huh? Like yellowgroove, can I have some? Come on over. Nice burgers. Oh, my goodness. Ground chuck. Lipton onion burgers. Lipton recipe secrets. Delicious.
a lot more than that. Facing a snowstorm is going to be a long video.